Plastic surgery is transformation. Once the last resort to combat aging and deformity, today it is the cutting edge. From life-threatening traumas to the endless search for beauty, plastic surgeons are shaping and sculpting humans into a perfection of form and fancy. Welcome to the world of plastic surgery, before and after. Americans spend hundreds of hours each week running, swimming, and pumping iron. Most are concerned with losing weight, while others want to build bigger arms or shapelier legs. What if you could have your legs sculpted to aesthetic perfection? Up next, a fitness trainer does just that to improve the contours of his calves. 33-year-old Craig Anthony is a personal trainer and former fitness model. His body has always been his livelihood, and he has been toning and shaping it for the last 15 years. As hard as he tries, however, Craig can't develop his calf muscles.
I've been working on my calves for a long time. They're okay. No one ever said, oh, you have small calves, or, you know, never lost the job. So if I have a bigger calf here, everything else will look more in proportion.
To help him achieve the calves he desires, Craig has decided on cosmetic surgery.
I thought about it for a long time. Yeah, my girlfriend basically said, you know, you don't need to do it, you're crazy, you have a great body, you know, why? But if it'll make you happy, or something you think you need, I could be okay without it, but it's something I want to do. People are always looking at you, you're always being looked at. And maybe it's just, you know, a form of insecurity, I don't know.
Craig researched several plastic surgeons and has chosen Dr. Ghada Afifi, a board-certified plastic surgeon in Newport Beach, California.
So, Craig, can you tell me a little bit about what made you think about having calf implants?
Basically, I've worked out for a lot of years and developed the body pretty well to where I'm happy with it. Mm-hmm. It comes quick, chest, mm-hmm. biceps, arms, quads, no problem. But calves?
Mm-hmm. Can't.
Wasn't really happening that good, so.
Calf implants were first done probably 1975. They were first used for reconstructive purposes, particularly after polio and also after trauma. After they were in use for reconstructive purposes, people started using them for cosmetic purposes.
Initially, Dr. Afifi said that something that triggered for me is the calf needs to be three-dimensional. It's not just a big back of the calf, it's the sides and the back.
Unlike the silicone gels that have caused problems in breast augmentations, calf implants are made in a solid silicone form, so there is no danger of leakage.
Two calf implants. We can put a calf implant right over what's called the medial head of the gastroc muscle, which is right here, and we can also put another implant over the side, the lateral head.
After years of contemplating plastic surgery, Craig has finally decided to have the calf implant procedure.
My mom knows, my brother knows, they, friends know, they say, don't do it. Don't do it. Look at yourself in the mirror, you don't need it. You have, you know, you're lucky to have what you have.
Early attempts at cosmetic surgery were not always as safe or successful as procedures performed today. In the late 1800s, a French ballerina went to her doctor to see if he could remove fat deposits from her calf. The doctor performed an operation using a spoon-shaped instrument called a curette to try to literally scrape off the fat. Unfortunately, the results were tragic as he damaged a blood vessel and the dancer ultimately had to have her leg amputated.
I'm drawing right now where your calf muscles are. The goal of surgery is to accentuate the position and the definition and volume of your calf muscles. 39.5, yep, there's the metric, okay.
Craig is prepped for surgery and the anesthesiologist begins his work. He is positioned and Dr. Afifi begins to inject his calves with an adrenaline-based medication.
We're injecting both sides with lidocaine, with epinephrine, to decrease the pain and bleeding during surgery. The only thing I don't like about it is it's so wide. Actually, this might work out pretty well right here.
A small incision is made in the crease behind each knee.
In calf implants, we're going above the muscle. We went through the skin and the fat and the fascia.
Dr. Afifi uses a long instrument to create a pocket for the implant.
The goal in making this pocket is to separate the fascia, or the covering over the muscle, from the muscle itself.
Two implants are placed in each leg to mimic the natural muscular composition of the calf.
Okay, here we go.
The team tries several different sizes of implants to see which combination best achieves the profile Craig desires.
Perfect. Usually this is a larger implant on the inside. Okay, now take a look at both. He's gonna love these. Beautiful. Very nice.
The incisions are sutured and Craig's legs are bandaged.
That's pretty good.
1 month later, Craig returns to Dr. Afifi's office for a follow-up.
All right, so I'm gonna have you stand right here and let's take a look. Okay, very, very nice. But your scar looks great. Your contour is beautiful. It looks like you've been working out. Did really, really well. Very, very nice.
Yeah, they look great.
Excellent. Okay, you did great.
Though Craig had a difficult time recovering from surgery, he doesn't regret his decision.
Well, I've never had surgery before, so it was just brutal. Really tough. But I unwrapped them, I looked at them, and they looked good.